purely electric. And second thing, the uniqueness of this is already run on road on almost 5-6 years. No, I am we are converting that into electric. So the thing is, the concept of why the retrofitting is, the adoption of electric vehicle on the road with the new vehicle is very difficult. And again, it is going to increase the volume of vehicles, because the old vehicles you cannot bring out. And if you bring new electric vehicle, the speed of that performance of that vehicle also will come down. And then the old vehicle also will be there. So you don't achieve the pollution reduction. So, and the second, the third is the sentimental value of your thing, that your own vehicle, I'm getting converted into electric. So I'm doing something for a environment as far as me also. That is the concept, that is the uniqueness of this product.
Can you show us how does this work exactly?
See, we have a battery, and there is an accelerator, and there is a brake. There is nothing like a clutch or a gear, anything. And there is a, see, for the balance, weight balance, center of gravity, we have put two batteries in the front and three batteries at the back side. Means we have to put in, because it's already has a space. We have to design this thing within the existing space. We have accommodated everything required in within the available space. So we have done this. So there is a battery. So there are three batteries in the back side, two batteries in the front below the driver, and there is a motor which is doing the motion part, which is taking care of the moving the vehicle. So this, since as Umesh already told, it's a PMDC motor, it has a better life, and it's a DC motor. So it is, and it is on IP65. If you take the auto, even dip the auto inside the water also, nothing will happen.
How much do you think the people could afford for this?
No, here, see, what we are looking at the, see, now in India, people always look at the government should already incentivize this thing, and so that I can adopt it. Now we have already got the indication from central and state government that they'll give you around 50,000-60,000 subsidy each. So it is costing around 1.9 to 2 lakhs as of now, since we are not done in a large volume. So this only R&D cost we are telling now. Now if we go on a volume, the price may come down. So we want to minimum burden the driver or the users. As well as if the running cost comes down, even the customer also can have a reduction in the per kilometer price also. This is a long-term process. So we have initiated it. Let us see. Let us work for together. As you think, as a media people, you also just support us. We will just move around.
What are the further plans? First, now we have seen the autos and single vehicle. So, yeah.
So further plan is, see, that's what I said. We want to convert which is running up to 3,000 kg vehicle or 1,500 cc vehicle. We want to convert into electric. And see, just converting the electrical also doesn't give you the adoption thing. You should have a solution also. Because after, see, if I say 80 km range, after 80 what? We need to give a solution. No manufacturer till today in the world has given the solution. So we want to put a charging and a swapping station ourselves, or with somebody's investment. We have already design concept is ready. People can invest, can earn also, and give their contribution to the society also. And the person using this vehicle also has a advantage that after 80 kilometer or 60 kilometer, 100 kilometer, he can just swap the battery and extend his distance. So the comfort, he need not go and wait for 2 hours charging or 1 hour charging, whatever is there. 10 minutes, just like you go to petrol station, how you change the petrol or CNG, this way. You just swap the battery within 10 minutes and you extend your this thing. That is what we are looking at.
After doing an R&D for 3 years, we came out with a battery-operated retrofitment of in-use vehicle, which is controlling the sound pollution and the air pollution, both. We dreamt of something like reducing the air pollution in all metros. See, we don't concentrate on one single metro. I want this vehicle to run all over India to control the pollution. And the advantages of this is that the auto driver is going to earn a little bit more, and his lifestyle changes once he earns more money. So we concentrating on auto drivers, we did this auto. And the likewise, we started doing on Tata Ace, Winger, bus, school bus. We have already started doing till up to bus. Now, right now, our ready products are auto rickshaw, Tata Ace, and car, all the three.
How unique it is from the other different cars which are already running in the batteries?
See, the price. Major thing is price.
Indian,
see,
if, Indian.
And it is make in India. Our major thing is make in India. We want to make in India and sell in India. We have a lot of offers from abroad for export. But still, when we have not done it or when you have launched here, I don't think so there is any this thing for exporting. We will launch it here in India. We will run some vehicles in India. Then we look for export.
What kind of technologies are being used here?
See, this is a PMDC brushless motor, which the life of this is around 25 years. And the battery, the unique battery what we are using is a carbon foam battery, which has got a life of 3 years, and we have given a guarantee of 2 years. See, any other battery in the market right now, the lead acid battery, it runs for not more than 6 months. But our battery lasts for 3 years. And if I go for a lithium ion, it can go up to 5 years.
Can you show me an auto for the demo?
Yeah, sure.
Today I'm traveling here in eco-friendly auto, which is launched today. It is very important to take care of your motherland. And this is just a step. With cameraman Vijay Chetan, Megha Chauhan, IBC World News.